वेलकम बैक व्यूअर्स टू लिसन चाइना थ्रेट थियोरी. वॉट इज इट? नेटो टू टफन G7 मैसेज टू चाइना वाई. सो लेट यू नो, प्लीज वॉच कंटिन्यूअसली. नेटो लीडर्स आर एक्सपेक्टेड टू ब्रांड चाइना ए सिक्योरिटी रिस्क टू द वेस्टर्न अलायंस. When they met on 14th June 2021 at G7 summit, a day after the group of seven rich nations issued a statement on human rights in China and Taiwan that Beijing said slandered its reputation. NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg has described the summit, which US President Joe Biden will attend for the first time, as a pivotal moment. Members of G7 aim to show that the seven-decade-old defense alliance remains a central support for US efforts to uphold peace and democracy around the world, including standing up to China and its rabid military rise. China does not share our values. We need to respond together as an alliance, said by Stoltenberg. China is coming closer to us. We see them in cyberspace. We see China in Africa. But we all see China investing heavily in our own critical infrastructure. Further, he added that diplomats also said like that. The NATO summit finally would not call China an advisory, and Stoltenberg said China was not an enemy but would demonstrate concern, calling it a systematic challenge to Atlantic security as it joins Russia with military drills, launches cyber attacks, and rapidly build up its navy. G7 nation meeting in Britain over the weekend scolded China for human rights in its Xinjiang region, called for Hong Kong to keep a high degree of autonomy, and demanded a full and thorough investigation of the origin of the coronavirus in China. But China's embassy in London said it was resolutely opposed to mentioning of Xinjiang, Hong Kong, and Taiwan, which it said distorted the fact and exposed the sinister intentions of a few countries, such as the United States. China's reputation must not be slandered, the embassy said, and replied like that. In that, China refused it at Beijing on 15th June, accused NATO of exaggerating the threat from China and creating confrontation after a vow from Western allies to work together to counter the challenges posed by its policies. But NATO leaders said that on 14th June 2021, they would join forces against the systematic challenges posed by China's policies, as US President Joe Biden reviewed Washington's transatlantic ties at his first summit with the allies. In a broad statement of intent, the leaders said China's increasingly assertive actions in building a nuclear arsenal and space and cyber warfare capabilities threatened the international order. In an angry response, a statement from the Chinese mission to the European Union called for NATO to view China's development rationally, stop exaggerating various forms of China threat theory, and not to use China's legitimate interest and legal rights as excuses for manipulating group politics while artificially creating confrontations. Further, it added that NATO's accusations were a slander of China's peaceful development, a misjudgment of the international situation and its own role, and it is the continuation of a Cold War, mentally and groups politics psychologically at work. But NATO Secretary General Jens said that the Allies would seek to cooperate with China on global issues like climate change, but decried Beijing's increasingly assertive stance on other issues. It came a day after the Chinese embassy in Britain hit back at the G7 for political manipulation after the group criticized China's human rights record in Xinjiang and Hong Kong. From this, we can able to understand the Cold War between NATO and China, which is mentioned as China's threat theory.